Okay, so if you're writing an essay that requires a hanging indent, we're going to go over how to do that here. But first, some setup items. This is an MLA format essay, so I'm using 12-point font in a readable font, which in this case I just chose Times New Roman. It's the most conservative choice. It doesn't specifically say you have to use Times New Roman, but if it's a readable font, you know that that one's fine. I have a 1-inch margin all the way around the paper. And you can see that if I go up to this ruler, and if you're not seeing the ruler, go to View and make sure Show Ruler is checked. If I left click on where the gray turns into white, you can see that's 1 inch. They should be all the way around though. So if you go to File and then Page Setup, check here, look at all your margins, and as long as they're 1 inch, click OK. The title of your Works Cited page should be center aligned, so that's this option on your toolbar. And make sure if it's only one citation, just take the S off so it's Works Cited. The citation should be in alphabetical order and they should be double spaced. So when you're checking your spacing, actually make sure that you get the title as well. And then go up to Format, Line Spacing, and the entire paper needs to be double spaced. So that's checked right now. This spacing is not driven by hitting enter twice at the end of a line. As a matter of fact, these lines, they won't format correctly if you hit enter at all until you're all the way done with the line. So in between the ending of this line, I just hit a space bar and then kept on typing. Once you have the hanging indent incorrectly, Google Docs is going to take your next line and indent it. So once you have these double spaced in alphabetical order, select just the content here, go up to Format, Align and Indent, and then come down to Indentation Options. Here at the bottom, you'll have a hanging indent as a special option. So select that and have it at a half inch. So that'll do the 1-inch margin plus a half inch on the subsequent lines, and click Apply. And there you go, that's done. So if you found that helpful, there is a video on how to do a full MLA format essay. You may want to watch that next. And if you like this video and want to see others like it, please click subscribe in the lower right-hand corner. And if you want to get little notifications of when a new video comes out, you can click that picture of a bell. Thanks.